And the business community might get just what they want. As the Philippine Central Bank Governor Benjamin Diokno says, the public can expect more cuts in interest rates and the reserve requirement ratio before the end of this year. For more on his statement, we're now joined on the line by Governor Diokno. Good to have you back with us, Governor Ben. Welcome to the program.
Good afternoon, Kathy. Welcome to your good afternoon to your listeners.
So how soon before the next move comes, and what is it going to be? Is it the triple R or the policy rate?
The triple R requirement is always on the table. It's an active issue. My long-term goal is to reduce the RR ratio by to single digit by the end of my term. But the public can expect an RR cut before the end of the year, for sure.
Yeah, you said on July 10th, the reduction in policy rates may happen ahead of another cut in the bank's triple R. So how soon before you cut the triple R anew?
The triple R can take place anytime this next month, as early as next month. But we will have another policy meeting in six weeks from now, and we are going to discuss a possible 25 basis points cut. Okay.
So the triple R cut could come between now and before the sixth week, before you meet for the next policy meeting?
Possibly, yes, possibly.
And what in the data would compel you to cut the triple R anew?
No, of course, you have to look at the liquidity, but you know, but even before any parameters or data that we are going to look at, it's really very high at the moment. It's one of the highest in the world. So we're really convinced that it needs to be cut, and the sooner the better.
Right, because when you check with June Neri of BPI, and I spoke with him this morning, he made a mention of M3 growth. It remains low, despite the last triple R cuts, while bank lending remains above 10%. So the additional triple R cuts really look compelling at this point.
Yeah, but to be fair, it's partly or largely because of the slowdown in the disbursement in the second quarter, right? And this is partly because of the delay in the approval of the 2019 budget, and also because of the election ban. But I can assure you that with a cuts of plan of the national government, the disbursement public spending will soon accelerate.
So how deep will the follow-on triple R cuts be, and where would you want the triple R cuts by the end of the year?
We will have a discussion. The monetary board. I cannot commit when, but it's gonna be the public can expect a cut maybe within the next few weeks.
And
we meet every week. We meet every week, so we have policy meetings every 6 weeks. But we can, as I said, it's an active issue on the table all the time, and so we can decide anytime.
And does that keep you on track for a single-digit triple R before 2023, before your term ends?
That's right. That's my commitment.
Now, you've reiterated your 50 basis point rate cut plan for the rest of the year. What in the data would you be looking for to affect the next policy rate cut as early as next month?
Well, we still have to look at maybe by that time we'll get the August inflation rate. We'll look at what's happening externally. We will look at the consumer spending in terms of retail sales and other things, right? Because it's too early for us to look at the third quarter growth. We're in the midst of the third quarter, right? So that's not going to be available 6 weeks from now, but. So principally, it's the inflation rate of this month, August. So by that time, it will be available by then.
That's true. But just how doable is 6 to 7% growth still for the full year, in your opinion?
Yes, that's entirely possible. And given the 5.5 second quarter growth, I asked the the technical stuff to review what's possible, and at least the lower bound of the 6 to 7% growth target is entirely possible or doable. Okay, so it's a matter of accelerating the build program, and we're confident that consumer spending will also increase with the lower inflation and higher remittances.
You know, the ratings agencies Fitch and Moody's have kept their current credit profile of the Philippines. The Philippines, as you know, has been enjoying the investment grade ratings, including S&P Global. But how soon do you think before the Philippines achieves its A rating?
We have actually a roadmap, and roadmap to A, and we're confident that we'll get it in years' time.
How soon?
2 years' time.
In 2 years' time, because retired Deputy Governor Ginigundo did speak about getting that upgrade to A in 18 months, and that's what he said 2 months ago. So are you delaying it for
months,
another
6 years?
18 months to two years.
2 years, yes. That's the target. That's the roadmap for A rating. You have to guide that.
On another issue, I know that you've cited you're working with other agencies to monitor the online gaming industries. What risks are you wary about and are trying to keep from roiling the financial system?
Well, it was initially the multi-agency task force was initially provoked by the concern of Secretary Dominguez that there's probably tax evasion among these POGO players. So that, but at the same time, we're looking at the risk on financial stability of this activity. So what would be the impact, for example, on real estate should they decide to exit, right? Because that's the nature of these activities. They can easily enter and exit. So we're looking at its impact on financial stability.
Do the risks posed by the online casinos become greater over the past couple of months? And if so, what's causing this greater worry?
Well, we'll find that out. We're not sure what is the risk of this activity. Right now, I don't think it's a big part of the economy, the 7 trillion economy. But it's good that we look at it at this time where we still, it has not actually blossomed into a full-blown source of foreign exchange for the Philippines.
All right. Well, I hope I haven't kept you, as I know government workers have now been allowed to go home because of the heavy rains, Gov.
Right. This is I'm reversing answer right now. And
oh, okay. Well,
pretty rainy here.
All right. Well, do take care and have a great weekend.